Sorting arrays in JavaScript is not straightforward, and it doesn't matter if we talk about array of numbers or array of strings or array of objects. There are certain pitfalls you should avoid. Let's see them. Hi, and welcome. My name is Ryan Pokorny, and I like to write JavaScript. I also like to read JavaScript, and I like to talk JavaScript. And in my weekly videos, I share tips and tricks, I review code, or I dive into built-in functions like today. So if you are new here, consider subscribing. Sorting is one of the most common operations we perform as programmers. And computer graduates know that sorting is a big topic in general. You have to know all the algorithms, they differ in the complexity, you know, the big O notation or the memory consumption or other things. In the modern JavaScript, we don't have to deal with that, but it's still not as easy as it might sound. When we talk about sorting, it implies order. And in JavaScript, there's one structure and it's array, which maintains order. So we will be talking about sorting an array. There is a method on array prototype called sort, which does sorting. It does not do what you might want it to do. So what does it do? First, it sorts the array in lexicographical order. That means alphabetically. That is no good for numbers, for example. And I would argue that it is bad for strings too. Let me show you why. So for numbers, if you have an array of numbers and you sort it, like just like that, it will be probably wrong because 10 will be before 9. In most cases, that's not what you want. It can work in a very special cases, like imagine one digit numbers, but that's a very special one and you should not rely on that. Fortunately, you can pass a comparator function to the sort. The comparator function always receives two items and it's supposed to compare them. And it should return a positive value, zero, or a negative value. One thing I heard very often is that it has to be 1, 0, or minus 1. That is not true. It can be any positive or any negative value, and it works just fine. So for numbers, what you can do is that if you receive A and B, you can return B minus A or A minus B, depending if you want to have an ascending or descending order. And to be honest, I never remember which one is which, and I have to try it myself. For strings, it might seem that it's solved, but actually it is not, because if you don't have a simple English words, it doesn't work either. In many languages, the order, how you should order words is different. Plus you have the special characters and maybe you want to deal with uppercase some in a special way. Again, the normal sort will not handle that. But JavaScript thought about that and has this function on string prototype. It is called localeCompare. And there you can pass all of these arguments. You can pass the locale, of course, and maybe the how it should handle numbers, how it should handle ascendance, like the special characters or anything like that. So there is a way, but you have to read the documentation and you should really know what you do, and it will differ case to case. One thing I don't like about the sort method is that it works in memory. That means that it doesn't create a new array, but it mutates the original array. On the other hand, that can be a good property because from the computer science point of view, it doesn't take more memory than needed. But for me, in practical use, I don't like that. What is super confusing and it can lead to big problems is that sort method is not stable. Well, let me rephrase that. It's not guaranteed to be stable. And this is a big problem because it may be stable in the engine you use. So for example, in browser you test in, the sorting can be stable, but in, I don't know, some other browser or maybe on some version of Node, it does not have to be. It's not guaranteed. The standard does not talk about that. Stable means that it somehow maintains the original order. So if you have a list of people and you first sort them by height and then you sort them by age, the non-stable algorithm does not guarantee that the height will still be sorted. So this can be very confusing. A small note about performance. The built-in sort is not fast. Like, we know that it's not a super fast thing. It has some heuristics, but still it is not fast. However, I would say that for most use cases, it is good. If you have tens or hundreds of elements, that's fine. I mean, you will not see any difference. If you have more, like thousands, tens of thousands, maybe millions, then you should definitely write your own sorting or use a library, because that will be much more efficient. Remember that the big O notation really applies to a really, really big end and not for small number of elements. What are the takeaways? I would like you to remember two things. First, sorting is messy in JavaScript and it's not as easy as it seems. And second thing, when you use the sort method, always, always pass the comparator method, because the built-in one is not doing what you want in most cases. I'm sure there are some other tips about sorting arrays. If you have them, please write them below and help me and yourself and other people get better. Thanks so much for watching. Definitely don't forget to subscribe. And if you appreciate the video, like it. And let me know in the comments about the future videos you might want to see. My name is Robin, and I like to talk JavaScript. See you next time.